Thor and his fellow Asgardians travel the Nine Realms using the Bifrost. It's an Einstein-Rosen bridge, or wormhole, which has a very distinctive look, hence its nickname, the Rainbow Bridge. Einstein-Rosen bridges are actual solutions to the equations of general relativity. They're warping of space-time that can connect two very distant points in space via a shortcut through the wormhole. Now, we're not actually sure whether nature allows for these solutions to the equations and how we'd actually go about making a wormhole. One thing we can be sure of, though, there's no way they'd have that distinctive rainbow look. Whilst white light, like that from the sun, is composed of a spectrum of colours, all of the colours of the rainbow, each with different wavelengths, frequencies, and energies. According to general relativity, all light, irrespective of its energy, takes exactly the same path. There's no way that a warping of space-time can give you a separation of the colours of light. So let's instead ask the question, are there rainbows out there in space? Rainbows form because of how light travels through water. The speed of light is less in water than it is in air or in a vacuum. So when it encounters water, it slows down and bends in the process. This is known as refraction. But the refractive index over the visible spectrum, essentially how much light slows down, isn't constant. This is known as dispersion. So the different colors of light end up bending by different amounts, leading to the separation of the colors of the rainbow. When this happens in a spherical droplet of water, what you end up happening is that white light incoming gets bent by 42 degrees back on itself. This comes out of that water droplet as a cone, which we see from a far distance as a rainbow. The near vacuum of space is incredibly low pressure and incredibly cold. So what happens when you take liquid water and expose it to space? The first thing to change is the pressure. That drops down, which actually causes the water to boil. Only then does the temperature start to drop down and the water freezes into absolutely tiny crystals. This behavior has been verified by astronauts when they released their urine into space during spacewalks. But what it tells us is that the liquid state of water is not allowed in space. But what about on other planets or moons? We do know other worlds that have something like a hydrological cycle, just not using water. For instance, Venus has suspended droplets of sulfuric acid, and the Venus Express mission was able to capture an image of a phenomena very similar to rainbows. These things called glories are what happens when the light doesn't actually enter the droplets, but they're still affected by their presence. Similarly, Saturn's moon of Titan has liquid methane, and we think this could cause methane rainbows, which would be 10% bigger than the rainbows here on Earth. We've not actually observed these because Titan's atmosphere is incredibly hazy, but there's no reason to suggest why these methane rainbows shouldn't exist from time to time. But there's another optical phenomena that looks similar to a rainbow, which might actually exist in space. Halos. These are essentially exactly the same as rainbows, but instead of liquid droplets, we're talking about ice crystals. Halos are actually far more prevalent on Earth than rainbows ever are. And because the shapes of ice crystals can take so many different forms, they produce some amazing patterns, which can be incredibly variable depending on the orientation of the sun and exactly what ice crystals are present. Now, whilst we haven't observed halos on other worlds just yet, we do think they should exist due to the physics. In fact, some people have worked out what they think the ice halos on other worlds should look like. And as I said before, ice crystals can exist within the near vacuum of space. So it should be possible for a rainbow-like phenomena to come from these ice crystals as light hits them. So if you want something that looks like Thor's Bifrost in space, what you really want is an ice halo. Thanks so much for watching this video. I do hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already to get the latest physics stuff, and do hit that notification button so you don't miss my next video, and I will see you soon.